Dobry wieczór państwu.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'd like to thank the organizers for the invitation, and I will speak about the myth of identity of and the persistence of architecture. So let me start with the permanence, the myth of permanence of memory. And let me start with what one of the actors in the Polish comedy said: I like only the songs that I've heard before. How can I like a song that I'm hearing for the first time? This saying is obviously always relevant, and it expresses in a fairly accurate manner the assessment of architectural objects, not only by professionals, but also by lay people. It relates to the sense of ontological security, so what we consider true, safe and beautiful is what, in the view of our experiences, the signs, the structures we have seen before, is considered as such. So we are dealing here with a certain myth of interpretation. We do not take into account the fact that in view of the changing reality, the signs, symbols, structures have become the antonyms of the ones existing in the past. So let's attempt a different approach to the assessment of architecture while maintaining this dualism of interpretation, so assessing both the content and the matter. In the past, the architectural objects have been interpreted in the same way as organic matter, as human body, for instance. And living organisms do not die at once. It's a process. So first of all, the parts of the brain responsible for interpreting, for collecting data, for contacts with the external world, these parts of the brain die out. And these are the parts of the brain that developed in the process of evolution as the last ones. It is the soul of the humans. During this time, we still breathe, our heart still works. And in the same way, we can approach architectural buildings. So the content of architecture at the first stage, it also evolved last. The matter has been still existing, is still existing. Ladies and gentlemen, this is related to the phenomenon of overwriting. So the dying out of content results in the death of a building or in its reinterpretation through the content that comes next. We can talk here about over-interpretation with reference to this material content as well as the spirit of the building. So it's overdriving, palimpsests are the concepts that come up in this context. We are dealing with perception, recalling and imagining. I have differentiated certain attributes of permanence of architecture. So because of the lack of time, I'm not going to discuss them in detail, but let me just point out to the method of use architectonics. So also the sort of clothing of a building, its artistic aspect. And in the same way, we may refer to this facade of references that determines dynamically of the building. Now, let me proceed with some examples that illustrate what I have said before. This is the building of the previous local authority's office. And in this case, the building has been reinterpreted both in terms of content, so the spirit, but also the matter. When it comes to the content, this building logic, the authority has gained this culture-making function. There is also a myth from the 14th century that was discovered in the basement, but I would like to point your attention to the materiality. We are looking at the facade. This facade has been restored, renovated, and most of us will be convinced that the materials used are historic materials. This is how we experience them, how they feel from the textile perspective, visually. But, in fact, the materials are a perfect replica. The chemical composition is completely different, and they were created on the basis of the state-of-the-art technologies. So, is it historic matter or no longer so? And yet another example, a building of a former train station. There is no longer any train that is passing by. And in here we have a good example of this replacement of the spirit. So we have some attributes of the previous form, and now the building is used for residential purposes. Now let's move on to the myth of time. The myth, the time goes by, but the myth of architecture is permanent. Let me start once again with a quote from Leibniz. So the time is not autonomous, it's a consequence of the events. Without the events, the time loses its meaning. The time redefines the sense of existence of a building, its durability, its beauty, its usability. One important aspect in the case of architectural objects is the persistence of its identity. When we want to determine this persistence of identity, we should answer two questions. First of all, who am I? What am I? Obviously, in the case of a building, and where am I? In the first case, we get a clear answer of what the building has become after being reinterpreted. In the second case, the answer is equally important, because the nearest context of the building as a result of various changes has modified the impact of the building and its influence on the observer. And let me give you one more example. This is a pretty specific building. Maybe it's provocative. It's a residential building made of prefabricated modules, and at some point a kind of overgrowth appeared on the roof of the building. It's also it also has a residential function. So the building hasn't changed its function, but is it really true? Can we speak of technological persistence of this building? Well, it has been substantially modified. This facility, this building, was originally constructed differently than what is constructed on the top. Paradoxically, this bottom part has not been overhauled or renovated in any way, so there was a suspicion that it would have been would have been changed as the in the first priority. But what happened was the contrary. First of all, this annex was added on the roof. Well, how about the aesthetic values? In the case of this kind of buildings, you can't really speak about beauty, but the reinterpretation of aesthetics obviously took an important turn. But maybe there is something even more relevant, even something more important in this specific case. There is something that exists outside of architecture, but has direct impact on its functioning. This building from prefabricated elements was supposed to democratize relationships between residents. And as a result of this annex, you get a sort of a luxury residence that is in a way superior to the rest, and the residents of that annex enjoy higher status than the residents of the remaining flat. So this is a non-architectural criterion, but it seems to me highly relevant to the analysis of this case. And yet another example is the cemetery of the spirit. So this place, this site is devoid of its meaning. At certain stage, this functioning has been frozen, and it seems that this facility, this site, has lost its function, but it continues to be visited by tourists. For instance, some of them are not even aware of the history of this site. And finally, the persistence of matter, of symbols, and metamorphical persistence, material persistence. The myth of architecture as something permanent can be explored in two ways. We can explore this matter metaphorically or physically. How can we define this in the easiest way? It seems that the best idea is to use antonyms. In the first case, we would have a dispersed structure of masses, and in the second, multi-layered systemic compilation. The slide shows a reinterpretation of the metamorphical persistence, but there are two different aspects. The first one is the replacement, continuous replacement of the content, and the reinterpretation of matter. It is commonly believed that persistence means continuity. In the case of architecture, we can speak of this immutability in two ways, as the separation of space for specific events, or the matter, the material that is used to create such separation. And this material can be persistent, can be durable, such as glass, such as cement, or it can be illusory, it can be temperature, it can be smell, it can be something like dependencies or ergonomical dependencies, or some products of our contemporary ICT technologies. And finally, before I conclude, symbolical persistence. When we speak about symbolic persistence, if an architectural structure is symbolically permanent, well, it is. when it comes especially to its original purpose. We can speak about the Royal Castle in Warsaw, in Krakow, about the Royal Castle somewhere else. Well, none of the Royal Castles is the house of the king anymore. They also stopped being used by officials. In the case of the Royal Castle in Warsaw, the entire material structure of the building has been replaced, but the name still remained. In the case of the Potocki family palace in Łańcut, well, it's no longer owned by the Potocki family, but the name continues to be used. So the name of an architectural building site structure is assumed by the site where that building used to be located. So maybe some of you have read the Alice in the Wonderland, and there was the smile of a Cheshire cat without the cat itself. So it seems to be an analogous situation. Okay, so maybe I will not go into details, but just let me touch upon the classification of the permanence of matter of existing and dead objects. And this metamorphism also created the conceptual ideas of structures. And now actual metamorphism of dead objects, matter, well, we can use in here the example of some old abbeys, old sites. So a relic becomes a sign of known values, of recorded events that are commonly known, but it happens that a structure becomes a sign to unidentify events. And finally, to conclude, maybe one more example from architecture. This is a reconstruction of a post-industrial facility in Silesia. This facility was originally erected from brick. And later on, during the reconstruction process, it was completely demolished, dismantled. The structure was made with reinforced concrete. I took this photo more than a year ago. I believe that this building is once again layered with a brick, and it even looks, or in no time will look in this way. As you can see it now, it's a kind of simulacrum, because we look at it and we perceive this building as a building made of brick. Is it true? And maybe to sum up, very often when referring to architecture, we think about its physical durability, permanence, but it seems equally important to think about the permanence of architecture outside of its materiality, so its permanence in myths and in memories. Thank you.